You ready?
Yeah.
Is that our best one?
Yeah.
Really? Okay, I thought it was pretty good. 7 easy steps. Step by step goes the marching band. Dang it, I keep putting that down. There. Step one, you already know it.
Write what you know.
The student body definitely is low income. 95% of the students here qualify for free or reduced lunch. They represent what the world is really like, the diversity of the world. Not only the world, but the future of the world. The world is mixing together.
What do we do with the variable? So is this going to be x squared? No.
I got involved with this school a few years ago because I noticed some really powerful instruction that was happening in the algebra class.
This is where students, they either get this stuff right now and they get confident with it, or they don't really take the time to get really good at this, and then they don't like math. They get frustrated. They stop coming to school.
Yeah, I basically copied everything Mr. Munn does, from his curriculum planning to his instructional strategies, and infused some of my own things and took some things from a number of other great teachers that I had encountered and observed, and I'm just using them. They're just things that work.
We're going to spend a lot of time with this and make sure that everyone really gets this.
You know, what used to happen here was my kids would get a pretty good experience in my class, and then they'd move on to the next couple classes, and it was like they just went right back off the cliff.
It's perfect. Perfect. Perfect.
And having John here now, it's like I know once they're done in this room, you know, they're going to end up in his intermediate and pre-calc class. And we have this now capstone calculus course, which is just generating so much excitement. And it's the most popular class.
It's a big old fraction. Okay, so you're going to start with a quotient.
What you see up here on the stage is just a mix of techniques, all proven techniques.
How's that one go? No.
I want them yelling things out loud, and I want to go outside and hear it so that other people on campus can hear it, just because it's shaken up a little bit.
How's that one go? Thank you.
When it comes to specific techniques to meet the needs of, let's say, English learners, there's some specific things that, you know, color coordination, that type of thing.
First is F. Oh, wrong color. F doesn't change. Okay.
There's this girl, Sokno, and she said to me, Mr. Winn, I don't understand anything you're saying in class, but I watch what's going on the board. And that's how I learn it. And she's a top student.
So now we know what it is. Now let's make sure we can use it.
Mr. Winn, he's easy for me to understand what he's trying to tell, but actually I didn't like really pay attention to him, but I just look at how he did on the problem, and then I just copy it, and then I try to do it, and then I get right.
It's kind of like a little calculus jingle. Lodi high, minus highdy low, all over low low.
The stuff that we do in here, whether it's a skit, whether it's a marching band problem, whether it's some kind of interactive thing or a hands-on thing, it may or may not help that much with understanding the topic, but I think it makes class fun.
Gottfried! Gottfried! Wilhelm Leibniz! Where are you, son?
I saw this little thing about Leibniz in 1675 on vacation in Paris. I thought it was hilarious that he was doing calculus in Paris on vacation, which is, strangely enough, I've done that plenty of times on vacation, doing calculus. And so I call Becky up, say, you got a wig? You got a puffy shirt? Let's do this.
You, ever since your father died when you were six, you doing the things with the numbers all the time on the pieces of paper.
Oh, mother, be quiet!
Oh! Please,
for a student to come to a class and to always feel like something like that could happen, I feel like that's the type of thing that may encourage a student to sort of be on the edge of their seat. And that's how I want them in here. I want them, the second they walk in, ready to go, on the edge of their seat the whole time, bell rings, that's when you stop working.
When a group of people, 100 people out there, you, are all doing something, it doesn't even matter what, but if we're doing it at the same time, like reading off lodi high minus highdy low all over low low, saying that together is a way to practice our strength.
My definition of a teacher is just teaching the lesson and making sure that your students understand the materials that are taught. But sometimes he stays here with us until 7 or 8 o'clock at night doing math. And I think that's an amazing thing.
Crawford! Nice.
In a lot of ways, I use the ocean as kind of like a way to like just wash off the day. You know, like wash off the costume. I take off my tie, you know, I'm taking off the hat. Mr. Winn hat is being hung up for the day. Put that costume in the closet and you know, it's back to John.
And so for me, it's really important to have some little ritual that gets performed at the end of every professional day. Being out in the water tends to be a really important experience for me on a regular basis. Being on the edge of that wave, being on the edge of, you know, potentially falling off and getting crunched. And I've been out there where I've taken a bad fall and being in a really tough situation underwater and having to basically figure it out in that moment. And almost like a, kind of like a life or death situation. And I don't think calculus is life or death for the students, but I do think that when you're faced with a really tough problem, you either have the skills and the capacity to rise up or you don't. And I believe that the key is self-belief.
What do we know? Okay, we know a whole bunch of stuff. We better do them one at a time. Just put up a hand right here. What's something you know?
For me, it's really important to have consistency and really setting the tone that instructional minutes are valuable. And we're not going to waste a single one. This is serious business. And they're getting that homework done, and they're working hard in class, and they're asking questions. Why? Because this is serious business. And it's, man, it makes the teaching day wonderful.
Finish solving this system with substitution and take a look up here at what I have and make sure you have the same thing. Go.